I'm John Hardie. I'm the Chief Executive Officer of ITN. I'm looking forward to meeting the group from Go Think Big, and I hope to be able to give them any of the insights or experiences I've had that can be useful for them as they embark on their own careers. It's a real pleasure to meet you all. I have to put a disclaimer up front. I'm the Chief Executive of ITN, but I'm not a journalist. However, like all of you, what I've had since my earliest days is an absolute passion and love for television. Went to Glasgow University and I studied English and philosophy. One of the opportunities I had at Glasgow is Glasgow and still has a very good student television organisation. Things like media studies and journalism courses and things like that almost were non-existent in tertiary education. So actually, something like student TV was a tremendous way as a student to get any kind of experience at all. And eventually in my final year I ran it. As it came towards the end of my time at Glasgow, I thought, well, I'll go and work in television now. Couldn't get in. Applied for the BBC, and I don't think I've ever said this on camera before, but applied to the BBC training course. And despite the fact that I had been, you know, running Glasgow University Student TV, which was very well regarded, did not even get a first interview. And couldn't get into the local, you know, Scottish television because that seemed to be ruled by nepotism and you had to know somebody and so forth. So couldn't get in. So I became a marketing trainee for Procter & Gamble. And a big part of how Procter & Gamble operates is it sells through television advertising. And so I thought, well, that's kind of as close as I'm going to get here. I ultimately became managing director of a European division in cosmetics and toiletries. I liked the company. I liked what they did. But an opportunity came up and it was to be the marketing director of ITV. And I did it for about 4 years. And I read this book from the guy running Disney at the time, Michael Eisner, and it occurred to me that working, if I was going to be in television, working for one of the Hollywood majors might be an idea. And the phone rang one day and they said, we're looking for someone to run the television business in Europe. So I went to Disney for 8 years, and my main job at Disney was I was managing director of the Disney channels across Europe. So I had a wonderful time at Disney, but I hankered to run my own operation. And 5 years ago, my predecessor was leaving ITN, and the phone rang and said, would you be interested? And I'm now doing the best job of my entire life, and it's a complete honour to be able to run that organisation. So that's me, that's my entire life story for you. Give me some questions wherever you want to go on any of this. By the way, be as rude as you like. Okay, honestly, it's like, just say what you want to say.
So as an alternative to BBC News, in what way does ITV News present itself and persuade its audience to watch it, and how do you do this?
ITV News has as its obligation to compete with the BBC, to match the BBC in terms of quality, to get a very large audience, to appeal across the country. And then what I think we do in ITV News better than anyone is we get Britain right. That we understand the impact that stories have on the people who are in those news stories, and we reflect those and the impact those stories have on people in this country.
How do you think that do you view social media and mobile as kind of an opportunity or a threat to kind of traditional news organisations, really?
It's all of the above, because while 80% of people are watching their television news and bulletins, when you go down to the younger demographic, represented by some of you, obviously there's more and more, say, the place I go to more often for my news is some online source, or it's mobile usually more and more, at least for the first place to go for news. And we have to be there, and we have to be there in a credible fashion.
I think you said something about you want to diversify without it being too tokenistic.
Yeah.
So what's your mandate now about concerning that?
The mission is to be representative, actually, isn't it? And organizations across the media are not representative. What you have to do is say this is a long-term thing, which is, first of all, how do you encourage and access people from all kinds of different underrepresented groups who are interested in working in any aspect of what we do to make it more accessible for them to approach? So If you're, you know, if you're in Bradford, to take the obvious example, and you're watching a news program which is just wall to wall, nobody like us is appearing in this news program, you're less likely to watch that program again. So it's entirely in our self-interest to do it. I'm sorry, I feel like I've talked too much, and I didn't really do anything helpful at all in terms of career and anything like that. I think what I do believe in is you've got to stick with it. A few observations. One, you may find that the first opportunity isn't the dream opportunity. Do not be downhearted. Do not expect that you'll get the first dream job to come along. The second thing is, make the most of your first opportunity. And don't complain about it. Don't worry about it. Just stick your elbows out and let your voice be heard.